Hey traders, checking in on the stock market today. We started the morning a bit choppy, a bit unclear, but by the second half of the day, the bulls had certainly taken over. Closing strong, we're seeing the market go as quickly as it can from fear to FOMO, as it does so often from FOMO to fear and back and forth with our emotional swings. And we're going to be looking at some names that have clear daily trend changes setting up and what I would consider unclear trend changes, a little bit of a lesson on price action. Let's check it out. So let's talk a little bit about, before we get into the regular technical analysis, talking about what I consider clear daily trend changes and what I consider unclear. So looking at QQQ, you look at this daily chart and say, well, is that pullback from Friday, is that enough to be looking at that as a daily trend change? Some traders would say yes. I would not say that they are wrong. But for me personally, I look at the NASDAQ futures chart, which has more data and more hours of trading. And I can see that we have a higher low every single day, 6 days in a row. So for me, this bounce has not topped out yet in the NASDAQ to even be looking for a daily higher low. How did we see the low of Thursday break on Friday for QQQ and not on the NASDAQ futures? Well, the low of Thursday on the NASDAQ futures happened in extended hours, and we didn't break that at all during Friday's trading. So you look at individual names and you say, okay, well, is Apple, is this a daily trend change? I look at the size of the pullback. I want a clear rejection. I want bears to take over, ideally for at least a couple of days. But I would consider Apple a daily trend change. The pullback from the high of the bounce to the low of Friday was over 3%. So a 3% pullback, and then the bulls had to see enough follow through for a continuation move. Essentially, what I want to see is a bounce. I want to see bears take over. And then I want to see bulls overrun the bears taking over, because that shows me sustained buying, whereas bulls bought the initial bounce and then they bought the higher low into continuation, and that puts continued pressure on shorts. Anybody that shorted on Friday, and or I should say Thursday, and was in the green is now in the red, and that forces some short covering along the way. A name like Roku, this pullback is much more convincing for me. This pullback was 8% or so, and I would call that a daily trend change if we break to a higher high. On a name like even SPY, is this a daily trend change bullish? Is that a little bull flag? Again, for me, it's not convincing. And whenever I have that I don't know answer, I zoom out. Pull up the two-day time frame on everything. Two-day time frame. Has SPY changed the daily trend? Has QQQ changed the daily trend? It looks a lot more clear there. And we could say, no, the bounce is still underway. We're still getting follow through. But again, this is up to the individual technical analyst, and it's just how I shape what determines a daily trend change for me and what doesn't. In the end, it doesn't really matter, bigger picture. It just helps us organize things in our brain. So I'm watching the NASDAQ futures chart, which is still all bull. Daily inside bar from Friday broke bullish right at the end of the day today. We will need to break the high of last week for this move to have follow through. But if we do, that's going to show me that this bounce is still underway. We have not topped out. We have not changed the daily trend, but there's plenty of space for a daily trend change to take place. And again, what I said in the intro is very much true. You will be astounded, if you're newer to markets, excuse me, you will be astounded at how quickly we go from euphoria to fear and from fear to euphoria. The faster we go from extreme ends of the emotional spectrum, the more money those who know how to play this game make in a short amount of time. So what you're seeing now is the significant fear from 2 weeks ago translating into FOMO. You better believe that bulls that were fearful and uncertain and should I be buying and didn't buy initially, well, now they're just looking at a scenario, well, where do I buy? Do I buy into this strength? Do I patiently wait for daily consolidation? And that can certainly make things more tricky. I certainly like when it's nice and clear and clean and daily trend changes, but we don't always get what we want. So we can say one thing very clearly, the bulls have complete short-term control. We knew SPY was just looking for a weekly higher low. We knew the XLF bulls were keeping the market bulls overall content. And we've got an all-time high. So the bulls are in control on SPY. I would consider the next time we consolidate on SPY, anything above 371.88 as a daily higher low. So bulls have plenty of space next time we top out. FOMC is Wednesday. So we're going to be looking for some volatile market reaction then. But the bulls are going to be heading into that, at least with 1.5 more trading days to go, of course. But for now, heading into that, confident. So I'm watching the higher low everyday pattern on the NASDAQ futures for indications as to when this bounce that initiated to start last week has topped out. It is still an inverse head and shoulders pattern shaping up here, where if we fail to break this daily lower high resistance, we'll still be in a daily downtrend, but we'll be looking for that higher low with plenty of space to try the daily trend change. QQQ. So again, you look at it and say, well, is that a daily trend change? For me, because the NASDAQ futures chart is so much more clear, I'm sticking with that. But QQQ is going to be looking to test the high of last week, 319.86. And then from there, we're looking up at 324.33. IWM, all bulls. From the low, straight back to blue sky breakout with follow through. Higher low every day, 6 days in a row. When you see a pattern like that, keep it simple. If that pattern keeps intact, the bulls have complete short-term control. If that pattern breaks, we watch for hourly oversold conditions. We scout daily higher lows. But if we do not break that pattern, we are not going to see any daily consolidation. So 231.91 is our short-term support heading into tomorrow. And when we do lose that pattern, there is plenty of space for the bulls to be looking for a daily higher low. The financial sector started pulling back today. It's still easily in a daily uptrend as well. We've been watching that 4-hour rising wedge, which is still in play. At this point, my brain just recognizes, okay, 4-hour rising wedge, we're a bit extended, but I don't care about the 4-hour rising wedge anymore. What I care about is our daily uptrend, because I know even if we pull back another 2 days, as long as we hold 33.52, the bulls keep complete control. We're gonna see the FOMC reaction either significantly shift the probability needle into weekly consolidation for the first time in 6 weeks, or new all-time highs. If it's a bearish reaction, the daily uptrend will be at risk. If it's a bullish reaction, blue sky breakout. And in my opinion, today, we saw a bit of profit taking leading up into the FOMC unknown reaction that we're gonna see in 2 days. What was notable to me was the sectors that we've seen significantly correlate to XLF didn't do so today. Some did, but I'm looking at H, hotel, big green day. We've got Wynn, gambling, new high. Did see some profit taking there. We have the airliners, very strong bulls, no profit taking or consolidation there. And we did have energy pullback. So energy and financial sector pulled back, but the smaller subsectors, cruise liners, they weren't pulling back much. So we're seeing things break. You have the strongest market-wide correlations when there is high volume and when there is fear. And you see everything doing everything the same, tick for tick, on the 5-minute, 1-minute time frame. And as fear is alleviated last week into this week, you start to see things break correlations, or at least weaken them to allow them to do their own thing. And we're seeing it in, that's a perfect example, with just the individual smaller subsectors starting to do their own thing comparative to what XLF did today. So XLF daily uptrend is our guide to ensure the bulls have complete control, and a nice daily EMA 12 as a visual guide as well, which has held the last two tests. Healthcare, higher low every day for this bounce, 7 days in a row now. And we're at the high of the bounce. That is a big reason why IWM is so strong, because IWM is healthcare and financial sector much more than tech. So we've got next resistance level at 115.36. We broke that. So we're looking at 115.99, and then not a ton of resistance levels until the all-time high. But again, we have not changed the daily trend bullish. This is just a V-shaped recovery straight off of the low, and we will need a clear higher low and higher high for that trend change to take place. Bulls are hoping a monthly higher low is set. It's certainly healthy on the monthly time frame at this point, and if we do confirm a daily trend change, odds of a monthly higher low being set will increase a bit more. The biotech sector. So here's another example. You know, we broke the low of Friday on Thursday on Friday, just barely. So not enough to be looking at that as a trend change. As far as I'm concerned, the same bounce is underway. The bounce has not topped out yet. We've got resistance at 152.28, and we are watching the higher low pattern every day. But when it breaks, we have to ensure there's at least a percentage plus of follow through to believe it But XBI will be looking for a daily higher low to form once we clearly see consolidation underway. And we certainly have not seen clear daily consolidation since the bottom and the bounce started. Semiconductors. So here's that little higher low and higher high that QQQ is seeing. So it is a support level I'm going to pay attention to. 227.75. Next resistance is 241.55. Keep in mind that a lot of individual names that pulled back significantly, or sectors and individual names that pulled back significantly the last couple of weeks, even with bull moves, even with daily trend changes, we are watching for the possibility that weekly lower highs are going to be the result of this bounce. So we're at a scenario right now for the semiconductors where over the last 6 days, we've bounced 9%. But here we are still 9% from that all-time high. So are the odds favoring just a straight bounce to new all-time highs, or are the odds favoring a weekly lower high and tightening range a little bit, which could still break bullish, but there's a lot of names watching for weekly lower highs. SMH is in the gray area because 9% is not a huge amount, but if we look at a name like Roku, this next weekly bounce on Roku, percentage-wise, to get back to the all-time high, we're looking at 35%. So that's obviously a much different story as far as probability of a weekly lower high being the most likely scenario. TAN, so another one with a little bit of a pullback to end last week, daily inside bar today. So short-term support will be 93.02. The bulls want to break 99.16. Again, I'm still watching correlation to the NASDAQ. I'm still watching the NASDAQ futures chart with no daily consolidation. So I would not consider this a clear daily trend change back to the bulls if we were to see continuation from here. And again, you condense it down to the two-day time frame, and we have a bounce and now some sideways trading with no clear trend change just yet. MSOS, bounce continuing. We're getting a steady drip of New York potential legalization headline news helping this bounce get followed through and play catch up. I did add a little bit to some MSO exposure today with, I don't even know the ticker, it hasn't been burned in my brain yet, AYRWF, because I really like this clear daily setup, just double bottom, higher lows, and all-time high is right there, 3750. So made an initial entry there, trying to see weekly continuation, still got half of my MSOS position exposure. And same thing here, we need the daily trend change to see bounce follow through. We're in a daily downtrend at this point. Anything under 5070 is just a daily lower high. So we must see daily trends change on charts that look like this if we're going to see bounce follow through. Then we'll zoom out and watch for the potential of anything under 56 to be a weekly lower high. The dollar has a 4-hour tightening range forming. So low the pullback, higher the bounce, higher low, double top. It's a bit of a 4-hour equilibrium. Have to break this bullish if we're going to say our daily higher low is convincingly set. So if that happens, our daily higher low is 91.36 and we're looking back at the high. If that does not happen, then we're looking at our 4-hour support of 91.54 and the tightening 4-hour range. Gold and silver have to change the daily trend bullish. Has not happened with a daily higher low and higher high in a while. 2 months on gold. So you might be looking at this and saying, well, that's only 1 day of pullback. Why would you consider that a daily trend change? And again, it has to do with size of the pullback to establish the higher low. A 2.5% pullback on gold is significant. A 2.5% pullback on NIO is not significant. So the relative range of the individual ticker is important as well. And if we were to see a bull break of 1740 from here, I would consider that a clear daily trend change, and then I would zoom out and scout a weekly lower high to be the result of that bounce. For silver, the pullback was a bit more significant, and silver's volatility is generally more than gold, so that makes sense. Have to see the bull break of 2646. Keep it simple. If that level does not break, bears keep complete short-term control. Those levels have to break over the next couple of days. The miners are already at the high of their bounce. The S&P 500 at all-time highs definitely helps that, but it could be a scenario where the miners are potentially leading metals again. And if the metals change their daily trends bullish tomorrow, we'll say, yep, The miners led it again. Doesn't always work out to be that way, but it often does. And we are watching the next resistance level. The next zone is 5065. We're looking for a monthly bounce to try and take place on these miners. And a lot of work still to be done on these metals and these miners to regain the trust of the bulls after losing it over the last bunch of months. Oil tightening up on the daily, still a higher low everyday pattern, not every day, still a higher low pattern in the uptrend as long as 63.13 holds. If 63.13 is lost, we enter a daily downtrend and we get weekly consolidation for the first time in 6 weeks. Keep it simple. If 63.13 is holding, the bulls keep complete control. Natural gas, bears in complete control of the short term, daily bear flag. We're oversold on a lot of time frames, approaching weekly higher low, 242 support. There is a potential bottom fishing play off of that level. The 12-hour RSI is in the mid-20s. The 4-hour RSI is approaching the teens. On the next bounce, we will just be watching for a 4-hour lower high, but keeping an eye out for a potential play off of that weekly support. That being said, even if we hold 242, we will just be watching for a weekly lower high to be the result of any bounce. So bulls in control of the broader market, bulls still in control of the NASDAQ bounce, bulls still in control of the financial sector daily uptrend. FOMC is this Wednesday. We're going to be paying attention to potential volatility then. Continued decreasing fear in the broader market and increasing confidence. And we will be looking at bulls to buy daily higher lows once we see some clear daily consolidation. So I will continue to watch the NASDAQ futures chart overnight. I want to see a clear break of the high of last week if we're going to have confidence in it, in bullish continuation. And I will be watching the higher low everyday pattern as my guide as to when this bounce has found a temporary top. I entered today without clarity, and there just was nothing standing out to me as a clear play this morning, so I didn't do anything and patiently waited. And then along comes MJ sector volatility, and I see APHA shoot up in a massive way. And actually, the bulls shook me out shortly before the bull break took place. But what that allowed for is volatility to trade in both directions. So I shorted it and longed it. And again, just locked in my little base hits. All I need is just give me volatility and I can trade that volatility. So there was one scenario where I took a top fish on a 1 minute lower high, and that was here. So we hit our high, big pullback, looked for a 1 minute lower high. Actually, I take that back. That was too recent. It was a previous double top, 21.38 at the high here. So there were top fishing opportunities, long story short. And then there were long opportunities as well, even after the bull move took place. So I'm not going to chase the bull move and just buy, but I will buy 5 minute consolidation looking for a higher low. I was actually trading TLRY. That's why I'm not finding any of my numbers. I traded TLRY today. So TLRY, I scouted the 1 minute lower high at 31.17 here. So I saw a big enough pullback where I anticipated the potential of that 1 minute lower high, made my bearish entry, put my stop over the high, and we then ended up pulling back nicely. I covered it right around the 30.40s. And then from there, why did I cover it? Because I knew we were just looking for a 5 minute higher low. So I covered the short and I instantly looked long. I said, okay, 5 minute pullback, healthy, low bear volume, 5 minute EMA support approaching. I'm going to make one entry in the 30.30s and I'll enter one more if 30.30 breaks or if 30 breaks, and then I'll set my stop loss based on a dollar risk that I'm willing to take on the trade. Got one fill in the 30.30s and we headed up and hit a new high. So that was a nice little win there. And again, just volatility. When you're a confident day trader and you have volatility, you can find trades in both directions. Again, no home runs, no big winners, but just enough to give me something that I'm confident in. You give me a breakout on high volume and consolidation on low bear volume, I'm very confident a 5 minute higher low is going to form. I'm not confident I'm gonna nail that bottom, which is why I reserve multiple scale-ins spread out by 1%. And A lot of the time I don't need the second scale in, but some of the time I enter too early and I do. So volatility is a day trader's best friend, and it was being patient and not getting into a trade that didn't scream out to me as confident that allowed me to capitalize on this MJ volatility when it presented itself. And again, no huge win today, just another little green base hit day, which is now, after starting the month, 4 red days in a row. It's now on 7 little green days in a row. None of them notable, but all of them base hits, keeping the steady uptrend going, which is what we want to do. And I have no idea what direction or what I'm going to be trading tomorrow. It depends on what the overnight session for the NASDAQ chart does. So I hope you're well. I hope you do good things. Keep an eye on zooming out if you are lacking clarity. And other than that, that NASDAQ futures chart with the higher and low everyday pattern is where I am finding the clarity for this week. See you tomorrow. Dancer, came dancing.